is good. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. 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 You meet every need. Hallelujah. You supply. Hallelujah. Glory to God. All that we need. Hallelujah. It's your provision. Hallelujah. In abundance. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. You're the God that's more than enough. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You're the Lord. Hallelujah. That sustains. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. We can sleep in peace. Hallelujah. We can awake knowing that it is you that keeps us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Hallelujah. Cause me to triumph. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Greater is he that's in me. Hallelujah. Than he that's in the world. Hallelujah. Cause me to win. Hallelujah. Giveth me the victory. Hallelujah. Through my Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Always causing me to win. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We triumph in the work of your hands. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Nothing of the enemy can hurt us. Hallelujah. No way can hurt us. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. We win every time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We come forth with victory. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Look what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. The Lord is on my side. Hallelujah. When I fear, hallelujah, the Lord is on my side. Hallelujah. My enemy, he always, hallelujah, he's my strength. Hallelujah. My shield and my buckler. Hallelujah. My strong tower from the enemy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. You're my strong tower. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Giving me authority to win. Hallelujah. Gave me the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. I go forth in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Nothing of the enemy can stop me. Hallelujah. Glory, the gates of hell can prevail. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Death has to bow down. Hallelujah. Sickness has to go. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Depression can't stay. Hallelujah. The joy of the Lord is my strength. Hallelujah. Glory. I draw from that well. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The everlasting fountain. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Make our cup run over. Hallelujah. Give us more in the name. Hallelujah. You give us the anointing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. We are anointed of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Full of the Holy Ghost. Full of faith. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We'll go forth. We'll go forth. Hallelujah. Day unto day. Hallelujah. Me and my son. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Father. Glory to your name, Father. Hallelujah. Everything that concerns us. Hallelujah. Everything. All of our business. Hallelujah. All of our family, the household. Hallelujah. Everything. Everything that pertains unto life and unto godliness. Hallelujah. We have. Hallelujah. For you freely give it. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory. Hallelujah. Greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Great is my God. Hallelujah. My soul maketh boast in you. Hallelujah. Others are here, they'll be glad. Hallelujah. They see and they hear what the Lord has done for my soul. Hallelujah. 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 Glory. Glory. What a word. Thank you. Give it up. I'm all sound. I have not pleased to see the goodness of the Lord in this land. Hallelujah. I have not believed that I would be well. Hallelujah. I would be delivered. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Hey, I would have been done. Hallelujah. But the Lord, hallelujah, has become my strength and my song and my salvation. Hallelujah. Strength of my life. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord has become my salvation. Glory. My deliverance is in God. Hallelujah. Glory. 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 Hallelujah. We're full of faith. We're full of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. We can make intercessions. We can give thanks. Hallelujah. Glory. Pray for others as well as ourselves. Hallelujah. Make up the hedge. Stand in the gap. Stand in the way of the enemy. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Spirit is working in me. Hallelujah. Giveth life. Hallelujah. Glory. Giveth life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Surely, surely the Lord is on our side. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. We declare that Jesus is Lord. Hallelujah. To the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah. 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 We thank you, Father. I give you praise and glory today. We gather as a people of God. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We thank you for being in our midst. Hallelujah. In your presence, fullness of joy. Right hand, pleasures forevermore. Hallelujah. Glory. We ask what we will. Hallelujah. You give it the desire of our hearts. Hallelujah. Pour on us. Hallelujah. Pour out your blessings. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory. We ask according to your will. Hallelujah. We know that you hear us. And whatsoever we ask and you hear, we know that we have. Hallelujah. For great is my confidence in my God. Hallelujah. Great is my confidence in my God. Hallelujah. All I have to do is ask. I'll remind you of your covenant. Hallelujah. I will remind you of your word. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Thus saith the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth, the sea and all that's in it. Hallelujah. Thus saith the mighty God. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Is anything too hard? Anything too difficult for you? Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Show me your word. Hallelujah. It runs swiftly. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Your word is fast. Hallelujah. Glory. Accomplish what you sent it to do. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Deliver and heal. Set free. In the name of Jesus. Give the victory. In Jesus' name. Well, somebody in here that's well, shout hallelujah. Somebody is healed, shout hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Please, somebody that's been delivered. Yeah. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. You know where you come from if you're delivered. You've been set free. Hallelujah. Whom the Son set free, he's free. He's free for real. Hallelujah. He's truly free. Hallelujah. Glory. Well, now it's time to run through a wall. Oh, glory, hallelujah. I can just pray for another 30 minutes. Glory. Hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. Yeah, wow. It's easy to pray in the Spirit when you get in this kind of environment. Man, I should be boldly asking for something. Boldly make your request known. Hear me, Father. Hallelujah. Glory. Hear me today. Ye, Lord, mercy. Hallelujah. Going from strength to strength, faith to faith. Hallelujah. I might ask for something real big in this kind of environment. Glory. Hey, he, my son. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank God for this day. We prayed for about 20, 25 minutes. We didn't get yours in. Something's wrong. Gonna get someone to lay hands on you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Well, we've been focusing on prayer the last couple of weeks. Just last week, and Pastor Hill talked about that Sunday. Amen? Amen. Okay, and we want to just kind of have a lively, open, kind of frank talk today, because we all need one another, amen? Amen. And I did speak with Pastor Hill earlier today. He says he won't be here today. He's out of town. I didn't ask him who gave him permission. Preachers that do stuff like that. Okay, praise God. So we want to discuss our responsibility as individual saints and as corporate believers. And we want to discuss and assume responsibility, discuss the assuming responsibility, and also hear about some benefits and experience that you've had in your life through prayer. What would have happened without prayer? Could you have made it? We already know the answer to that, don't we? Amen. What would you be? What would have happened if I had not believed and prayed to see God bring me through? Can you think of some times, maybe some real hard, tight squeezes? I have to think back, because y'all been saved for a long time. Some real tight spots. Boy, if it wasn't for the Lord there, I would have never came out of that. You waited on God. Just waited for deliverance to come. Waited for God to show up, and he came through in a big way. Can you think of anything? Any time. Anybody that you might want to share. If it wasn't for the Lord, man, I don't know what it would have just opened. Anybody? Yes, sir.
I guess it was getting Dylan back from PHS. That was the biggest blessing. I mean, I was to the point where I got down on my hands and knees and just prayed and prayed, and if it wasn't for the Lord, right when I prayed, the very next day, everything changed.
Oh, wow.
The tables turned, everything started going my way. So, you know, I tried to do it by myself, and I knew that was the wrong thing to do. Got down on my knees and prayed and told the Lord, please, you know, get my son back. And the very next day, everything started changing.
Praise the Lord. Amen. How about that? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. The devil thought he had you down, had to be. Had the game won. Score already pronounced. But he called on the Lord. Hallelujah. Anybody, anyone else? Yes, go ahead.
While we were dealing with DHS, we had a worker who was, she kind of did some things that weren't necessarily right, but we never said anything. We just prayed about it and prayed for worker who told us that she was going to help our family, which is something we hadn't heard from the other one. And so I think God has really carried our family very far through prayer. It brings us closer together, and I know that Dylan can sense a difference in us as well. And, you know, I had a very bad drug problem in which I was on life support and had been on dialysis and was pretty much almost dead. And God called me up out of that dark place into a place in which I can minister to the same exact people who are going through the same thing.
Praise the Lord. All right. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
Man, we're talking about when the rubber hits the road. Praise God. Got to make a difference. Got to have it, something different going on. Praise God. Anyone else? Amen. You know, if it wasn't for the Lord coming through, been there, bringing deliverance, just where would be your address today? Well, you say, Sister Denise, I knew you was going to jump up. You can't take all night, you know, Sister Denise. I got other folks.
No, I just said I would get down because I wouldn't be sitting here.
All right, praise God. We've heard her testimony many times and how the Lord has brought her through, and she just wanted to put her name up there and say, I know it was the Lord that brought me through. Praise God. Amen. Anyone else? It could be anything trivial to traumatic. You know, because, I mean, you couldn't do it, even the trivial stuff. You couldn't deal with it. It was minor. It was beating you all upside the head, had you all kept tied and everything else, and you just wasn't free. Anybody think of anything?
Amen. But now I was getting ready to, I think it was wings and full legs. But anyway, I was getting ready to come to Bible study, and all of a sudden it looked like I was trying to come down with a cold.
Okay.
And I started praying in tongues.
Ah.
It left.
Praise the Lord.
I love God.
Praise God.
And it was really coming down to my head started hurting, my nose started running.
Mm-hmm.
I just started praying in the spirit and telling the Lord, Lord, I know that. I
want to go to
church. I don't
want
to miss that.
All right.
I love
to have
this cold.
Praise God. That's good. That's good. Amen. Praying in the Spirit. My spirit praying. My spirit's got life in it. Praise God. Life produces life. Hallelujah. Amen. That's good. Anyone else? You just knew you was done. You have a different address today than went for the Lord. Amen. Well, okay. Maybe you can think of something a little bit later. Praise God. But maybe we can talk a little bit about the importance of prayer in the life of the believer and this corporate people, a corporate body of believers. And one of the things, like we heard the testimonies just this evening, how many have been uplifted by hearing what you heard from across the room or over there behind you, what have you, praise God. And, you know, that's, we have a responsibility to have a prayer life and to make known His deeds, what He did for us. We know we call on Him, we know we pray, we know we was just flat on our back, and if God didn't come through, there wouldn't be nobody coming. Praise God. And it's our responsibility to let others know that, to hear that, so they can know the power of prayer. And I think that's one of the most neglected resources in the world today, perhaps maybe even in the Christian circles, is the power of prayer. I don't think that we... you know, say, got to get there so I can get in that prayer. Got to get there. Don't want to be in prayer without, you know, I don't want to get there and prayer's over. And they talk about something else, you know. I want to be in there when they're in there praying. Because that atmosphere, that environment is charged up. And then I get in there and I'm going to come say something to God too. You know. And when I'm by myself, I don't sound so good. But when I got about 100 voices, when they can't hear me, no one has to know who I am. So I just... just say what I gotta say, praise God. And you know, and I know that I'm in there in corporate prayer, and those other folks' prayers taking mine up with them. And I'm all mixing with that, all that faith and all that. Going from, that's what you call going from strength to strength, faith to faith. Someone else can ride on your prayer that's weaker than you. They don't know that, I didn't know you were supposed to, like the brother said, cry out. You know, some folks are, you know, like Presbyterians and, I don't know, some quiet people. You know. You know, listen, no. We need to pray. We need to cry out.
Yeah.
You need to say something. And that's really, when you get like that, it shows your boldness, your confidence. Bold, confident enough to ask, and you got confident enough to know that you're going to get it. If you ain't got enough nerve to ask, then you probably won't get it. You probably don't have faith if you're not confident enough to ask. Anytime you ask, most of the time you ask Brother Wendell for something, you expect the word yes. She don't expect you to say no. He ain't gonna say no. He's gonna get a yes and get it accomplished. Because that's the way it is, you know. You say yes. So you make it happen. And how much more so with the Heavenly Father? If you ask and you know He wants to, He's gonna bring it in if you brave enough, confident enough to ask, and then to share with the rest of your church family or Christian brothers and sisters. Look what the Lord, this is what the Lord did. I absolutely asked for this. I requested this of Him. It was hard for anybody else to make it happen. As a matter of fact, it was a tough request in the natural. I mean, it was nothing that I could have just, you know, whipped up and made happen. I needed something to happen. I need God to do it, make it happen. And then you turn around and tell somebody else, and that right there will boost them up to say, you know, I'm going to ask my little old deal that I've been struggling, tied up with. I'm going to ask. Sorry about that. So you know, that's our responsibility. So I want to hear from you others besides Dylan. Dylan's got a lot of faith. I remember he wouldn't want to say anything when he came over here. Last week he was checking out the whole fellowship hall. Keep on, praise God. So he's getting there. Okay. All right. Someone tell me, what do you think is your chief responsibility when it comes to prayer? Then include this church. What's your responsibility when it comes to being an active member in prayer in this church?
First of all, we need to be more diligent if we're not. And do more praying, but not always just be selfish prayers, just for ourselves, but for the pastors, for the congregations, sisters and brothers. I mean, because some of them may not be, you know, praying. Somebody pray for us, most of us, you know, at some point in our lives. So we need to be encouragement to one another. And sometimes just picking up a phone and calling somebody, and they might be discouraged today.
Okay.
Or just bless each other and pray with each other, you know.
Okay. All right. When you don't see a certain member, a member in a long time, they hadn't been in service on Sunday or Wednesday or any other time, what's your, someone, you know, Brother Charles, you ever see somebody around, you know, been missing in action? What's your... How does your gut do? Where do you, how does that fit with you?
I noticed, so when I came here, I kind of not had a, you know, a relationship with, it kind of, it bothered my spirit. So the first thing I do is I make that phone call. And then once I make the phone call, I get them online. And then, you know, we'll talk and I see, you know, what's going on or whatever. So when that person opened up, then, you know, the spirit will tell me to pray for that particular thing.
Right.
And I pray with that person over the phone.
Right.
You know, and so when that happens, then a couple of days or a week later, the manifestation already done.
That's right. That's right. And you think you have encouraged and built that person, showed some love, concern?
Yeah.
You probably saved that person from?
Yeah. Yeah.
From?
Several.
He sure has. When I needed it, he was right there, right on time.
Okay.
It encouraged me and brought me back.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Yeah. So you can see how we absolutely need one meets the other.
Yes, exactly.
One needs, we all need each other, praise God. You might think that he don't ever need me. He can handle it. He can deal with it. You know. That's a trick of the hood of the devil.
Mm-hmm.
Let them handle it. Leave them alone. No bother. Then that's a trick of the devil. Because he knows he's got them in a corner, beating them upside the head, left and right. And he don't want no help coming in there no kind of way. And we look around and we don't see, we don't hear, don't know.
No. The more you get into the Lord, the more hurdles you're going to have to jump. You know, that's what Brother Terrence told me, and boy, was he right. They were coming at me everywhere.
Amen. Yeah, once you set your mark and you're going to go with God, that's one of the biggest lessons that a new convert, and I had to learn that too as a new convert, that you ain't fought nothing yet. You ain't fought nothing yet. You know, so and you need that spiritual intervention, that fellowship, that love, that those prayers. You really need them. Paul says, think about all his letters. He talks about I pray, I'm praying. I pray this, yes sir.
And then you got to realize too, even the ones who are strong in prayer, they also need encouragement.
Amen. Right. Amen.
Because there's so much constantly pouring out, so they need to hear something from somebody.
That's right.
It won't take much, but you
that's
know,
right. That's so
I
true.
Mean, just the boots. Just
the boots. I sure hope y'all pray for me. Yeah. I can tell when y'all praying for me. Lord, I'm broke. What do you say? Why am I dealing with this? What are them saints? There ain't nobody praying. Come on. What's going on? But everybody needs prayer. And it's responsibility we have one for another to create an atmosphere of prayer. Always have an environment where when someone comes in here, they can ride right on you know, just wherever you are, they just step right, come sit next to you. You think they like you because they're sitting next to you. Oh, this brother's, he's on fire. I'm going to catch one of his hallelujahs and ride it up for a while. And about 10, 15 minutes later, that person starts opening up.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hey. Yes, Lord. You might not hear them. Yes, Lord. Amen. Yes, Lord. They're catching away. They're riding on up. Praise God. That's why prayer is important. Okay. Anybody else? Experiences? Oh, I gotta find me a church. Let's go to another church. Why do we need to pray? If you was talking to a newcomer today on the phone, out in public, somewhere, and you said, brother, sister, you need to pray. Well, how would you explain to them, why do I need to pray? And now, some people think it's now I lay me down to sleep, I pray a little more. So that was my bedtime prayer when I was a teenager and a kid. I didn't never want to go to sleep as bad as I was and not get stuff straight for the night somewhere. I want to wake up in the morning. How many said that prayer? Now I lay me down to sleep, I pray the Lord. Okay. <You know? laughs> Tell Mr. Jones' prayers, but you know. But that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about why do I need to pray? Now I'll share with you. I get on a call every week, every Tuesday at 8:30 from California about 6:30 that time, with a group of professionals, and all we do, we call it the Mastermind Conference, and then we also have started it up on Wednesday morning at 8 o'clock my time, 6 o'clock their time. That's early, isn't it? 6 o'clock California time. I get it easy, 8 o'clock. No problem, I'm up. Can you make the call, Williams? Yeah. 8 o'clock. Here's what they was talking about. You know, what can you do? How can you be motivated? How can you set your sights? How can you have a vision? What does it take to make it succeed in the marketplace and so forth and so forth? And what are your strategies and all this kind of stuff? And the majority of the people on the call, from Jew to Gentile, said prayer. They said, you got to have prayer. You got to have prayer in there. And one guy said, you got to have your quiet time. You gotta have your quiet time when you first get up, whatever it is, you gotta have your quiet time during that day. And then and they said, and you also got to have some prayer in throughout your day, in your life. You got to have it. I mean, these are people who are making money, living good. And that's all, the number one thing that they emphasized was prayer. And I'm thinking I'm on a secular call. You know, just talking, well, natural business. But there's prayer. So, what do you say to a new convert, young person in the Lord? You know, how would you emphasize that, brother, you need that prayer. You need some prayer time. Not now laying me down to sleep. That wouldn't qualify for what's going. You're going to need to get you through whatever's coming. Heavy stuff's out there, and you need to be prayed up. Even if you're trying to achieve something, what do you say to it? How can you get it through to a young person in the Lord that you need some prayer?
Prayer is a form of talking to God.
Mm-hmm.
And it's if you want a relationship with anybody, you got to talk to them to get to know them.
Mm-hmm.
So it's pretty obvious that if you want to get a better relationship, you got to communicate more with God. And for me, being that I'm a talker anyway, you also, like you said, have to get in the habit of having a quiet time so you can hear him talk back. Because if you just praying out, you'll never listen, how you going to receive? Just like if I'm talking to you, if I hold the whole conversation and you don't talk at all, I get nothing.
Right. Okay. Anyone else? That's very good. Okay. Anyone else? How can you get over to newcomer, old convert, a new saint, old saint, that man, you've got to get some prayer in your life, some prayer time in your life. And shall I go over there and ask Timothy while straight? I believe that. They got the sign outside. They said they're open. I'll bring the answer back.
You know, most of the time when people are going through something like that or contemplating something like that, they're operating on a hope. Let's say in the business realm,
mm-hmm.
They're operating on a hope. They're hoping that things work out. They're hoping that things go okay. Now, if we can kind of transpose that and say that forget about your hopes, put in some prayer time
mm-hmm.
to the person that can actually make that happen, or the individual that can make that happen.
Right.
You know, if that was someone that they could see, of course, they would believe in it. But you know, when we start talking the fact that God can do anything for you, they have to get that into their system to understand that as well.
Yeah, the question come up as you say that. When will people pray most of the time?
When they're in trouble.
When they're in crisis. They'll pray, you don't have to tell them nothing, do you? make way or nothing, just get out of the way. Then we'll pray like crazy. But to say include it in your life, you know, have it as a normal part of your life, build that in. And like in a business, people risk, I mean, they risk money, everything, to get that operation up and running. And until it about to crash, I hit rock bottom, then they start praying. Something like that. But if we incorporate prayer into our lives as a normal part, daily, all the time type of situation, I think life would go a lot more smoother. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the challenge to us and everybody, all of us in here, is to be, would be like, well, it's time you to pray. Curtis was saying, there's no one in this room right now more busier than him. Ain't no way, Jose. I mean, is it, Curtis?
I can't say that.
Aren't you busy?
You're a busy man.
Very busy man. I see him all over down the street all the time. He was riding, trying to get from one place to the next.
But, you know, I'm going to say something about that prayer.
Okay.
Like what you said, only time when somebody really wants to pray and a diligent prayer and who really want to talk to God is only when you're in trouble. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, when you're in trouble, you're on your knees, you're praying, but it's not a diligent path in the past. But in the past, I might be on my knees praying, get up, still the same.
Mm-hmm.
Still the same. Mm-hmm. You know, I ain't failed nothing. Mm-hmm. Ain't failed nothing. Mm-hmm. So when you're in trouble, you really want to pray. You want to hear something. You know, you sit on that altar, you know, you really want to hear that. When you get up, hey, it's a different attitude.
Mm-hmm.
It's a totally different attitude. So when most of the time when you pray, you ain't just praying just for one lead, you're praying for both leads.
Yeah.
You ain't praying for one of them, you're praying for both of them. You know, when you pray, you're praying for the whole part of the body. You know, and what I'm trying to say, you're praying for the whole part of this church.
Mm-hmm.
So it ain't just praying, it's praying for as a group and as a body. Because simple reason, if you just pray for yourself and yourself only, and then you get up, you're still the same way, selfish, mean.
Mm-hmm.
To me, that's not a prayer.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a prayer. Mm-hmm. When you get up, you should have a smile on your face, you should have a good spirit, and you should be in a better mood than you was when you went down there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So that's why I call it a prayer, that if a person really prays.
Yeah, when we're in trouble, and it's real bad, and I come in and pray, and you say, well, it's different than if I just do this routinely.
Exactly.
What makes that difference?
Because for every reason, you want God to hear you, and you want to get out of that trouble.
Hallelujah. What's behind that prayer this time? Earnest.
Right, exactly.
Like, kind of like, was it Jacob with the angel?
Mm-hmm.
You ain't getting out of here. You ain't getting loose until you what? Bless me. Lord, I ain't leaving this altar until I know that you're gonna do what I'm asking you to do. Woo! That's stand of business right there. Now, and we get an answer. So we have to learn to do what? Put some earnestness in our prayer life.
All the time.
All the time. Because people say, I go to prayer and it's the same old, yeah, and Travis is there, yeah, well, I'm tired of looking at him at number 7. Travis. Yeah, and you just get into a what?
Routine.
It's routine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
When you go in there and then you really push, you show up and push, And tell God, we taking care of business tonight because I got a mess going on and I need you. And, you know, you really get earnest. So the difference is, the Bible says, a fervent prayer of a what kind of man?
Righteous
man. If you get after it, you'll get what you want. If you get after it. So we have to get ourselves into a responsibility of not just routine, and it's part of life. Now, every Monday, it'll come Sunday morning. There we go, Wednesday again. No, we got to get after it. Praise God. If you want a difference made in your life, you gotta get after it. And that's a responsibility, because I gotta see some answers coming up in Curtis's life and hearing some testimonies from him. And I'm going, you know, we're going to routine again. Curtis will cook some chicken in another month or so.
Yes, sir. You know, also the scripture said, you know, all things whatsoever you should ask in prayer, believe, you know, and you should receive. So I think, you know, the key thing is just believing what you're asking for.
Amen.
You know, and not, you know, not just so much of hoping, but believing that God gonna do what you asking for.
Uh-huh.
You know, but the key is too, but you also got to be lined up too with
that's
the
right.
word for all of that to happen.
Absolutely, praise God.
So if it's not lined, if you're not lined up, you know, it ain't gonna. Not saying it ain't gonna happen, it might take a little longer until you get lined up, but you know,
yeah.
You got to line up.
Live it in God's will.
Yeah.
Living in God's will and ask what you will.
Yeah.
Living in God's will and ask what you will. So now that we find out we are responsible for one another, and we got to put earnestness in our prayer, and we need a prayer life. Because all of us have all type of concerns, different things going on all the time. What do you do to find or to get in a setting like we are in tonight, like from 7:05 to 7:25 again, we pray. What are we willing to do to create an atmosphere of prayer? What's the sacrifice? How much will we expend to have that? Ooh, Sister Shirley raised her hand.
Okay, and we still talking about new convicts?
New people? Because new people, they come around and they want to see something that's going on that's going to make something change. You know?
Okay, well,
I'm on drugs, alcohol, beer, wine, women, and all this routine. That ain't changing nothing to me. What y'all doing over here to make a change?
In order to get a prayer line, like, you know, everybody should have, I think they have to be in a good Bible study. Mm-hmm. I think they have to read the Word, and they really have to see the person that's talking to them. They got to have their life. They got to pray. You know, you got to have us. I have a certain time I pray. I mean, I pray all the time, but it's a certain time, like when I'm at home, my quiet time, and I read.